What was this Ella from Stop Me All channel? So we are just 1 week away from season 2 of Witcher. Now, I can't believe that it's already happening. Like, I feel like just yesterday I was reacting to season 1 episodes. And today I want to discuss my expectations. A bit loosely, in between seasons 1 and 2, I finished reading all of the saga. So right now I have much bigger expectations than ever, and I just really, really want them to respect the book material. Season 1 was okay, I liked it. However, it really simplified everything that happened in the books. Like, they changed some stuff did not make quite sense, that made some Polish people quite angry, because here in Poland, Witcher books are really a major and very important deal, because we don't really have as many famous things, you know, so you are very, very proud and protective of The Witcher. I think it just also makes sense, because if you read the books, then you know that the saga is so complex, and it's exploring the grayish areas of morality. It's really interesting, and I can only recommend it highly. I know that usually when you have a book adaptation, you just sort of tend to say that the book is better than the movie or the show. It usually is the truth. But in this case, it's just The Witcher books are so much better. So much better. I know that they are just sort of starting, like season 1. It didn't even reach the first saga book. We're still sort of circling around the short stories area, which are fantastic, but they are very different from the main saga. You can start with these. You can start with the short stories and it will be absolutely fine. They're very nice. They set up the background story. You're getting to know Geralt. You're getting to know Ciri. You're getting to know Yennefer, my absolute favorite, and Jaskier, who's a bit of a creep in the books. I actually don't want them to portray that exactly that way in the show. It wouldn't really fit. Like, Jaskier sometimes tend to be, I would say, even a bit rapey. Wouldn't want to joke about that. It's a serious topic, and yeah, I think Jaskier in the show is fine, more likable than the books. Jaskier, although later on Jaskier does get better a bit in that way. Anyway, but that's just a side note. We are heading towards season 2, and season 1 set everything up. It was a bit complicated to a point where Netflix had to release like a graph explaining everything happening time-wise, because they've been jumping. They've been jumping from the Sintra invasion by Nilfgaard, Ciri escaping Nilfgaard. They have been showing us Geralt and Yennefer's backstory, how they met and what happened in between them. They introduced Jaskier, they told us some short stories. They wanted to sort of show us that we are also watching a show about morality. However, I'm not certain if they succeeded as much when it comes to that. I have been marking like quotes about morality because I'm working on a morality video in Witcher, in that book, and like basically in every single book I have like as many marked, because I associate green with morality. That's maybe a bit of a cliche. So they've been doing that, and I really want them to go deeper in season 2. Even if they have to like literally quote the books, it's a fantastic material. I really want them to dig deeper. I think everyone wants that. I'm not certain if there are things that they can go back from, things that they did in season 1. Because of course, if you watch it without even having played the games or having read the books, it will be just fine. Like, it will be like a decent fantasy Netflix show. You don't really care about the books, you don't really care about the game, that's fine. We don't really have to all play the same things and read the same stuff. But there's just so much more to explore, so if you enjoy it, really is the only way to go. And games, even though they weren't obviously created by Sapkowski himself, games also respect the books material so much, because the CD Projekt is a Polish company and they all have read the books, and this is the reason why they created the first game, then the second game, and then the third one, which turned out to be a major hit. So there's that. I want them to go deeper. That's the most important thing I expect out of season 2 that's coming out really soon, and I'm so excited about that and making the reactions videos. They have skipped some of the short stories, actually. There are some really great ones. I know that they will do the Nivellen one. It's sort of like a Beauty and the Beast thing, so I'm happy about that, and I hope they spend enough time to actually explore it properly. Like I mentioned before, there's some stuff that I'm not sure if they can go back from, because I can't really explain that properly without going into a spoilery area. However, let's just say there will be some plot twists characters wise in the future, the way they already presented some characters, it just will be hard to undo that in the future, and it needs some undoing. It will need some undoing. So we'll see how they manage to keep that coherent. So I guess that's the second thing I would expect, to sort of present some characters in a proper way, because they need to consider that there's stuff happening in the future. They need to think about the stuff that will happen, and that we'll remember everything that happened in season one. So it will be sort of hard to switch that point of view. Again, I'm sorry, this might sound confusing, because I just don't want to say too many things, too many spoilers. So that's that. Next thing that I'm expecting out of season two, relationships. We know Geralt and Ciri, we know Yennefer and Geralt, we know Jaskier and Geralt, and Jaskier and Yennefer's dynamics. Actually, that's in the books, yeah. So we don't know that yet in the show, but we will. Blood of the Elves is a really relationships-oriented book. They focus so much first on Geralt and Yennefer, and then on Yennefer and Ciri, because these are the three main characters of the books, of the entire franchise. These are the characters that decided to be a family, even though they are not really related to one another, even though they are connected by some destiny bonds, but there's always something more than that, as one of the short stories told us. It doesn't really need to be as destiny oriented. Yes, Geralt and Ciri are connected, are bound to be sort of together by destiny. Is this all that matters? Without it, would they still be together? That's a good question that Sapkowski is asking in the books, and they did it in the show too. They respected that in the show. There's something more, right, than the bond that Ciri and Geralt have. There's also something more than the bond that Yennefer and Geralt have. We explored it in the Last Wish episode, which was based on Last Wish short story. What Sapkowski is asking here, would these characters still decide to stick together if it wasn't for the fact that there's some sort of a mystery wish that connected them, that there's some sort of a mystery bond that connected Geralt and Ciri? Would that still happen? Would they still choose to be together? And Sapkowski's trying to tell us that yes, they would still decide to be together. There are three people that were sort of rejected in one way or another. When it comes to Geralt, he was rejected from the society. Witches are widely hated in the society. They are not really accepted, you know? They are considered mutants and weirdos. So this is why Sapkowski's lessons about tolerance is really, really important. Yennefer's also a society reject. Like, she cannot have kids. She's not gonna lead the usual type of a life. She's not gonna find a husband and have kids and like take care of the house. Like, she's gonna be a sorceress. But she's willing to sort of risk it for Geralt. She's sort of willing to be there for Geralt. You will learn from hopefully the episodes to come. And I think that's really a bit of a spoiler. Like, you know that there's a thing between Geralt and Yennefer. They are both willing to dedicate their time and, well, their efforts to Ciri, who's also a reject from the society. So it's a wonderful grayish morally story about three people who don't fit in, who decide to fit in together. This is the most important lesson from the books that I just hope that they will show that properly in the upcoming show, in the upcoming season, because like I said, that season will be based mostly on the first book called Blood of the Elves. That first book, it tells us a lot about Geralt and Ciri's relation, and then about Yennefer and Ciri's relation, which is like my absolute favorite one. I love it, I adore it, like they have a wonderful one. It's kind of weird because people think Geralt and Ciri, right? But to me, when I'm reading the books, it's mostly Yennefer and Ciri. In a way, Geralt and Ciri haven't really spent as much time together as Yennefer and Ciri have, as you will find soon. So that's also really, really nice, and something that I bet they will talk about in the upcoming season, and I hope they will properly show that, these relationships, because it's amazing what Sapkowski did in the books, and it's just something that I really want to see in the show. First reviews are sort of okay, you know, people are happy. Apparently Netflix threw more money at the show. It's a show that's gonna make them a lot of money, as long as it's done properly. HBO always does amazingly executed shows. They throw a lot of money at them, like Game of Thrones is the best example. Season 1 of Witcher, it looked kinda cheap at times. Like, I feel like the sceneries weren't as expensive, the special effects weren't as good. So I think if they actually decide to have a bigger budget, then it will look better. Kaer Morhen, they're going to execute the wishes quotas, so that's something that needs to be done nicely. That's something that needs to look epically. We are going to visit the School of Sorceresses. I think we have already in Witcher 1, in the season 1. Yeah, so that also needs to look nice. We are going to see more of the elves. Definitely more of the magic. All of that needs a bigger budget and it's going to happen. Finally, we will see Ciri, because in season 1 she wasn't as important. She was just a little tiny mouse of a person running around and being scared and lost, which is understandable. But later on, Ciri becomes such a major important thing in the saga. She becomes one of the most important characters, if not the most important one. So much is going to happen to her. You wouldn't really believe, like, there will be so much happening with Ciri. She's gonna go through so many amazing places. The actress, I think she will definitely grow in season 2. She will get more chance to show her skills with the witches, with Yennefer. Hopefully the actress Freya Allen will grow into her role and show us what she's capable of. Yennefer and Geralt will also have to up their game. Honestly, I'm just so excited because we are entering my favorite book area, like Blood of the Elves. I think it was my favorite one because of these relationships. I read the book twice and I would read it for the third time. I think the entire saga, honestly, because it gets a bit complicated. I'm really happy about the fact that they will go back to some of the short stories, that they will focus on the book material, my favorite book material. I cannot wait. So do stick around because I will be posting reactions to the episodes. As always, I'm gonna have to cut them to, yeah, really short bits because Netflix takes down all of that. It's not easy posting these reactions. Netflix is very fragile about copyrights and whatnot. Obviously, I'm not aiming to show you the entire episode so you don't, you know, buy Netflix and watch it on YouTube, right? I guess my commentary is what's going to matter in case of these videos, so I'm going to do that. Stick around, it's just 1 week left, so I'll see you then, guys. Let me know your expectations when it comes to season 2. I'd love to discuss in the comments. Stay safe, again, join my Discord server, we can discuss that over there. You just need to accept the rules, people forget about that. Follow me on Twitter because I'll be posting updates, and that's it. I hope you have an amazing weekend. Bye, guys.